you know, if we pull back and look as citizens of this country, we're seeing sort of the toxic effect of this misinformation and disinformation.
In order to understand science properly, we have to have a healthy democracy. By teaching accurate science and recognizing how scientists think differently from other types of thinking, we are able to help produce students who are able to recognize this is bad thinking, this is a logical fallacy.
And what really attracted me to the entire curriculum was the, from the very get-go, baked into the cake, if you will, is this whole idea of addressing misconceptions, misinformation, and science denial. I was actually skeptical, like, well, teaching my students logical fallacies, is that really going to do anything? You know, but it was amazing because it opened their minds to seeing how they were being manipulated.
Students were really starting to look at what is being said and how is this information being communicated, and now they had kind of tools. Well, no, wait a minute, that's a red herring. They're just trying to distract me from this key piece.
The best part, when kids are two steps ahead of you and you don't have to spoon feed them, that they're figuring it out, you know, with their own problem solving.
And a student was like, well, there you go. That's how you cherry pick data. You know, if you only look at this, then, you know, you're going to get kind of the wrong conclusion of what our pattern is. And I was like, yes, yes, that's it.
Immediately they started thinking of their own social media that they consume. I could literally see eyes going wide as they realized, I've fallen for that.
By the end of that day, I was like, wow, this is like the best day of teaching I've had in a while. So I would just say, take the jump, get students interacting with their groups and with these hands-on activities, and you'll definitely see the benefits of doing so.